My name is Thomas Coppola. I'm the founder and CEO of Secure. Secure is a SaaS-based cybersecurity startup that's solving the biggest problem in enterprise security today. And I'm going to explain to you a little bit about how we got here, why it's so critical what we're doing, and why we have the best team in the space to execute. So let's get going. So first, a little bit about me, right? I've done three startups in my career. I've built an advertising platform. I built a commercial finance company. I've had three exits, totaling about $137 million in economic value. I started as a TMT banker. I've been a COO, a CFO. I've kind of done everything front to back. And my last startup was a massive success. We roofed 0 to 100 million in revenue in 5 years. And I was personally invested in all of those businesses, which is kind of the way I've always done things. So let me explain to you how we got here. Cybersecurity, why cybersecurity? All right. Cybersecurity, arguably one of the biggest markets in the world. It's poised to more than double over the next 5 years to about $281 billion a year. Yet, despite this massive spend, right, besides all this money, it's still front page news. Like, cybersecurity is really not getting a lot better. So let's really try and understand why. First, we live in this massively complicated world, right? We used to all work in a building with the data in the basement. We all went to the headquarters every day, and it was really easy to keep track of who is doing what with what data and what resources, because we all worked in like a headquarters, right? But now you've got 6 different devices. You're working from coffee shops, you know, across the ocean. You know, everybody's distributed. It makes the technology of solving these problems very, very complicated. But there's one single source of truth, which you can find in every large hack in the history of time. And that problem is this: us. Unfortunately, that's the truth. So while technical solutions like spam filters and mobile device management systems are important for protecting end users, they don't really come close to dealing with the multitude of threats that are facing today's global cloud-based distributed workforce, right? And interestingly, IBM did a study last year where they talk about 95% of all breaches can be attributed to some form of human error. Think about it. 19 out of 20 breaches were the result of us making mistakes. So what have we done? We built a platform to solve that. Secure is a language agnostic full stack authorization platform. It makes it easy for developers, engineers, and even business people to manage permissions for software and services, both across their own organization and other people's organizations. I'll explain to you how that works in a minute. First, let's take a quick recap. What is authentication versus authorization? Authentication is, who are you? Can you enter the doorway? Can you go through the doorway into whatever it is you're going to go do? But authorization is, what are you allowed to do once you get there, right? And authentication is well solved. It's a $15 billion industry. Everyone knows how it works. It's very commoditized. But authorization is basically untapped. It's basically the 800-pound gorilla. It's the largest problem in enterprise security, and it has yet to be solved. And there's a lot of reasons why, and most significantly, because today's systems weren't really designed for cross-organizational workflows, right? We started out manually configuring who can do what, and that grew into Google and Microsoft sign-ons. And we as an industry have adopted something called federated identities, which is great. You can use your own identity across the organization. But it doesn't address using your access to get to other organizations or to work with other organizations. There's no cross-organizational workflows engineered in today's solutions because we've never really thought about doing that. But if you listen to the research, that's really what we should be doing, right? The analyst Gartner will tell you that we need smarter access controls. We need decentralized management. We need better ways for machines and humans to coordinate over access to certain services. And that's what we've done. Because all authorization decisions are a result of business objectives, right? What happens is in an organization, you have people configuring and building authorization platforms for microservices or IDP solutions or sales functions or SaaS applications. And they're all kind of working independently because there's no common standard across the industry of a way to get these people to unite. And most importantly, these people writing code never really engage business leaders or the decision makers. And this creates a critical gap, which results in security breaches for organizations of every size. because it's complicated, right? Today, look what it takes to write a policy today. This is what it looks like today. You got to be a developer, an engineer, and you got to understand how to code everything, and you build your own libraries, right? We've made this process look like this. It's Lego easy. Who, what, where, and what's going on, and that's how simple it is. And the platform is phenomenal, right? Secure is the absolute easiest way to achieve enterprise-grade authorization. Centralized, single pane of glass, choice of deployment languages, no code, low code options, ties into everything you're doing. And it allows you to synchronize policies to automate functions across your organization or across inter-organizational relationships, right? We have worked on pioneering how to create trust between disparate organizations. And we made it very simple. We focus on three things: who has access to what resources, and how can they access those resources? If when you really think about it, it's really that simple. And the results are huge because we're based on block and we're building simple templates, which allow smaller organizations to get up the curve quickly in a policy as code and low code environment. It allows organizations to move into zero trust architectures in minutes, not days. And the key is this. If you look to the left, we, because we're written on block, we allow people from different organizations to work together to create the policies that manage authorization functions for all kinds of services across their organization and other organizations. Think of like a defense contractor, right? Which may have 35,000 vendors across the world. Now this, with our platform, this defense contractor can create templates of security frameworks and policies that are suitable for their requirements and compliance requirements across the organization and push them down to those 35,000 vendors. So now there's not a question of, is that vendor safe and secure to access my systems? I know they are because that vendor is using security policy templates and frameworks, which I engineered and pushed down to them. That is a game changer in the way we view security. It's changing, it's democratizing security in aggregate across the landscape. And when you think in those terms, suddenly it gets really exciting because we're not just focused on the IT side of it. We're not just focused on, oh, do you have a username and password? Are you the right person, right? You get into the logic of understanding full lifecycle permissioning for actions and services across both your organization and other organizations. It allows Secure to not just solve the technical problems, but to enable leaders to focus on the business of running their business and having better visibility. And the value is unprecedented, right? Massive reduction in security gaps, huge cost savings over the way we're doing it today, and really a better customer experience because now you can move data between organizations in an ultra mil-spec security function, right? And always know that everyone's following the same rules. Absolute game changer in the way we do security today. So how do we make money? Well, we have a consumption-based pricing model, right? Every query, every request by everyone in the organization, whether a person wants to access a service or an application, that query is sent to block, evaluated, and we deliver a response. And we charge fractions of a penny for that response, just like AWS or Slack or Snowflake. And so if you look at the industry in aggregate, that adds up pretty quick. Because interestingly, last year, 80% of companies globally said they were going to move to a global cloud-based IAM solution, right? And SMEs make up about 11% of the global authorization market today, right? Which is only about $2.5-3 billion. But that market segment is growing three times as fast as their larger competitors and is estimated to make up as much as 30% of the global IAM market over the next few years, right? So that's about a $10 billion opportunity in front of us. And although we're building for the enterprise and we're onboarding our first enterprise next quarter, which is awesome, right? A phenomenal benchmark for us. The real sauce is in the 400 million companies across the world who are smaller, but yet have the same problems, right? And 35 million of those businesses are already using OSO and OPA to write their policies, right? They're already using the languages that we write in to write their policies. We're giving them a platform to integrate and make it more simple and more visible across the organization. And we only need 500 of those customers to be wildly profitable, right? Because we estimate that those 500 customers are going to spend, on average, about $1,000 a month. And that should net us about $5 million in ARR over the next 2 to 3 years, which is just the beginning. And this is why. The authorization market is on track to overtake the actual IAM market, which has become a $15 billion market in the last 10 years, although now well set, well commoditized. But the authorization market is in its infancy. And for us, that creates massive opportunity because although we're starting with security policies, really our platform is built to manage authorization functions for all kinds of policies, both intra and inter-organizational. So sales rules and compliance rules and accounting rules and all the other rules that make up running a business. That to us is the massive opportunity. So sure, we finished our POC this year. We're onboarding alpha customers. We're onboarding our first enterprise customer next quarter. And we're going to continue to onboard customers in the first half of 2023. But most significantly, we're building things like a self-service portal and self-onboarding functionality for smaller businesses, right? And eventually, we're going to introduce things like Indie Ledger, Hyperledger Indie, right? Which creates for the distributed, decentralized identity database for users across multiple platforms, right? We are integrating into this ecosystem, which has been defined of the way security is moving. We're democratizing security across organizations in a way that's never been done before. And we definitely have the team to do it, right? As a team, we're about 12 people right now. We have 5 advanced degrees, including a PhD and a bunch of MBAs. We have 2 patents to our name, 3 more provisionals in the pipe. But most significantly, as a team, we have 9 successful exits to our credit, totaling over $800 million in economic value. And I did 3 of those exits myself personally, right? So we know what we're doing. We know how to build. We know how to scale. We know how to market. So let's do a quick recap, okay? We've built the first graphical policy authoring interface in the industry, right? Which allows you to write in multiple languages and then allows you to test and deploy with the click of a button. We have 2 patents under our belt. We're in an $80+ billion market. So there's plenty of room for us. And I know there's a couple of the teams in the world working on this problem. We finished our proof of concept this year. We have 2 alpha customers we're onboarding now. And I'm excited because we're delivering the first true policy management as a service in the industry. We've only raised about $300,000 to start. We have our POC out of the way. We have a killer UI UX, and we've built a robust set of APIs, which allow us to integrate to the biggest platforms in the cloud space. But most significantly now, we're going to raise $2 to $3 million in our current seed round to expand our development team to integrate even more functions and tools to enhance the platform for users across the space, including enterprise customers. We're going to rack up 500 paying customers over the next couple of years and do $5 million in revenue. And most significantly, again, we're not just focused on the security side of it. To us, it's the chance to help organizations manage all authorization functions from accounting to sales to senior management across their space. And we're building a marketplace of best policy practices so that organizations can push rules making frameworks between themselves in an effort to better share and manage data in an inter-organizational capacity. It's a game changer in the way we view security. And this is where our raise is kind of going to go. Most of it goes to R&D and sales, some in the G&A, some for infrastructure because we've got to expand our environment. As I stated, I've already invested $1 million in secure. So I'm more invested than any of you are going to write a check. We're solving one of the biggest problems in enterprise technology today. We've pioneered both the graphical user interface and easy onboarding and deliveries. And we've got patents around this to protect a lot of what we're doing because it's definitely proprietary. So I would ask, if you look at where you're going to invest capital today and you look at the problems to be solved, we've got one of the best teams in the space who's proven in what they've done. We understand the problem in the market. We built a phenomenal platform, and now we're raising money to scale and ramp up customer acquisition over the next 2 years. Help us do that and help us democratize the way organizations view and manage authorization functions today across companies of every size. Thank you so much for your time and attention. You can reach me at Thomas at SecureSYCCURE.com. I appreciate your effort in watching this video, and I appreciate the opportunity to have a dialogue. Thanks so much. Cheers.